I love writing C. It's small, it's simple, it gives you almost no tools to work with, and you sort of make your own language out of it. What I don't like about it is having tools to build my code. And it gets even worse when using those tools feels like chanting an arcane language to the screen. Like, hello CMake, where are my for loops? I hate it. And I feel like we most do, and we are somewhat forced to use it because it's the best tool for the job. Or at least that's one of the lies we keep telling ourselves to keep using CMake. But what if we didn't have to? What if we could use the language we so much love and understand rather than all the alternative toy languages? In my last video, I talked about Mate.h, a single header build system for C in C, where all you need is a compiler. And for the past few weeks, I've been working on it tirelessly to make it as stable as possible. So today I'm announcing the version 0.2. It's still a toy project, and I don't recommend using it for anything other than personal projects, but it's already capable of compiling in multiple platforms' big source code, like Raylib and Lua source code, which both are around 30k lines of code. I'll talk about performance later, but it's decently fast. It's also very simple, which was the main purpose of it. I don't want it to be a huge mess like CMake. If you want that, we already have it. I want something practical that I can just copy and paste when starting a new project and move on, and actually write code. I also want to write as little platform-specific code as possible. That's why Mate.h contains an std called base.h, which has a lot of cross-platform functions for file system. For example, file read, file write, file rename, file delete, etc. As well as data structure functions like vectors and arenas, among other things. It even has an ini parser, since that's the format we use to keep our cache. Anyways, making sure all of this works correctly on each platform is difficult. That's why we have a ton of tests that check the essential functions on each push. So I can be sure it compiles and works on Windows, Linux, GCC, Clang, TCC, and even MSVC and MinGW. And we have similar tests on Mate.h too, like compiling Raylib source code, Lua source code, and Samurai source code on each push as well. One of the main issues slash critiques in the past was that the build system used Ninja, and it was just a Ninja wrapper, aka a meta build system. It also stopped it from being a build system in C for C, just in C. Now that dependency is gone, at least for Linux, since we're using Samurai, a Ninja rewrite in C, which is compiled on the first run of the program and later cached. We are working on porting Samurai to Windows, and Cyan Ido, one of our main contributors, is working on making it possible, but it's still a far goal ahead. Now let's look into the fun part, but before that, a segue into our sponsor. If you were having a hard time understanding what is a build system, Brilliant is perfect for you. Brilliant allows you to choose from a vast array of topics, from computer science to math to problem solving and more, with thousands of interactive lessons, which will help you tremendously to get started and learn advanced topics about programming. With Brilliant, you get smarter every day, which is almost mandatory nowadays as a programmer. Its lessons help you build your critical thinking skills through problem solving and not memorizing, which is a very effective way to actually learn topics. So, to try everything for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/lewoski or scan the QR code on screen, or you can click on the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. If you want to try using it, first you need a C compiler installed. I recommend GCC. Then you need to go to the Mate repo and download Mate.h. After that, you create a Mate.c file on the main directory. And I'll keep this example simple, so let's say we're just building a main.c file. First, you need to include Mate.h, and above it, you need to add the Mate implementation macro, which contains the implementation of all functions. Then you define the main function and add start build and end build. These two functions manage initialization and proper cleanup. Then you create an executable. We set the output as main, which depending on your platform will automatically become main or main.exe. And then we add flag warnings, which is a generic flag which sets the equivalent warning flags depending on your compiler, whether it is MSVC or GCC or TCC. Then we add our main.c, which is at src directory. Then we install executable, which compiles all the files you added, in our case just one. And finally we run our output file. Now to run this example, all you need is the compiler, so you can just type gcc mate.c-o mate and run mate. Once ran, it will create a build folder and run your executable. After this, any change you make to your main script will be detected and it will be recompiled automatically, so you can just run it like this. And the same goes to any change you make to the source, of course. It will only recompile the files you changed. The rest will remain untouched thanks to incremental builds. So if you have three files and you just edited main.c, it would just recompile main.c. This is the most minimal build file you can create. But in one of our examples, we have how to build a Raylib project depending on platform, where you know in which platform you are by using islinux, as well as how to use glob patterns to make adding new files easier. In this case, it adds all the files that end with .c extension. Okay, so I promised I would talk about performance, which is a hard topic by itself, since you have to be very methodical with your tests and make sure you test the same thing. And my benchmarks were made pretty fast, so take all of this with a grain of salt. Parsing the configuration alone takes around 10 to 20 milliseconds. Most of the time is spent on compiling, so speeds depend a lot in your compiler. For example, compiling the Lua source code with GCC takes 1.4 seconds in average on the first compilation. After that, it takes 350 milliseconds average thanks to incremental builds. But then you take a compiler like TinyC, which is made to be fast to compile and has minimal optimizations, and the first build just takes 500 milliseconds. And subsequent take 300 milliseconds, which is around the same as GCC. This compared to the original make file that uses GCC, which takes 3.5 seconds in average and 700 milliseconds for subsequent runs. Now, honestly, this is no surprise, and most of the speed can be attributed to Samurai, since it makes parallel and incremental builds possible out of the box. And we've already seen, in terms of speed, how Ninja is way faster than Make in many occasions. But in terms of simplicity, the Metascript is just 28 lines of code, meanwhile the original Make file is 220 lines of code, and a lot less readable than pure C code. But anyways, for anyone interested in contributing, we have a small Discord where you can report bugs, ask for help, and talk about C in general. So join! Also, we have a list of to-dos of features we want to implement, so you can take a look at those. We also could use more tests, both in base.h and meta.h, so both are welcome. And we're also taking feature requests, though as I said, this is meant to be a very simple build system, so don't expect your crazy ideas to be accepted.